Hello, and welcome back to From the Workshop. I'm your host, Brandon Hart, and we find ourselves mysteriously once again here in the NimbleLink Nerd Lab. Wanted to take a little bit of time and talk to you a little bit about, we talked about what the Skywire modem is and what the XBee socket is and what AT commands are and different things like that, but I wanted to kind of give you a good tip, I think, on the best way to initially kind of get started working with the Skywire modem. A lot of times people are tempted to jump right in with an Arduino shield or start designing in a custom board from scratch without ever having actually talked to the thing. And I think that's a mistake. So I really highly recommend that you take a look at the development kit options, but look at the first one that's listed there. It's going to be this guy. This is the Skywire development kit. It's a pretty clever name. It goes also by the acronym Skywire development kit, SWDK. So if you're looking on DigiKey or Arrow or Symmetry and you see the SWDK, Skywire development kit. Okay, good. Got that established. So, this is the Skywire development kit. What makes it so special? Why do I think it's the best place to start? Let's talk about that. So first off, the Skywire development kit is just a single board right here, and it's got a few interesting features on it. When you order a Skywire development kit, your very own kit will not only come with the Skywire development kit itself, the main board, but a whole box full of things. So let's check out what comes in it. First off, nice little piece of paper. Piece of paper tells you to stop and go out to the website and download the documentation. Take a look at what's there. The user manual has been updated. I think we're on the 10th revision at this point, and that might date this video because now we may be on 11 or 12 or who knows what. But we try to really keep the Skywire development kit user guide updated, so please do refer to that. That'll walk you through all the steps, a lot of the things we're going to do here today as well. But when you take off the foam, you'll see that there are a few different things. It comes with a USB cable, power supply, only one single antenna, and we'll discuss that idea here in shortly. The Skywire development kit itself and a SIM card to get started. So those are the basic contents. We're not doing a whole unboxing video. There are other channels on YouTube for that, but this gives you an idea at least what's coming in your kit. So after you unbox it all, get your Skywire development kit out of the box, you'll notice that it has one connector for an antenna on here. Now that's fine if you're using one of the GPRS or even some of the HSPA Skywire modems. If you're using some of the CDMA stuff like the 1XRTT and EVDO, because they really only require one antenna. However, if you are using an LTE Skywire modem, I'll just show you what I mean. So here's a HSPA Skywire with just one antenna connection on it. And here's an LTE Skywire modem with two antenna connections on it. This is for receive diversity. LTE does require that you use two antennas. It is a MIMO technology, multiple in, multiple out. So you really do want to have both of those antennas connected. So what that means is on your Skywire development kit, there's only that one connection right there for an antenna. So you may need to get a second antenna to make those devices work. Not a convenient little spot to connect that up, but with this little adapter cable, you can put in any other type of antenna that you might want. Now, for the purposes of this video, I find these guys right here to be a little unwieldy. These are excellent antennas, but they also tend to fall over. So you can either bend those back like this, which works out quite well, or if you have handy access to other antennas like this little one from Tauglass, you can pop that guy right on there and off you go. So let's talk about how these actually go in. So the one thing you want to be sure of is these use an XBee socket. The XBee socket is not keyed, meaning you could put the Skywire modem in either way. So just make sure that you're putting it in this way right here. So this will give you the antenna connection closest to the antenna itself. So you can just simply pop that right on right there. Okay, great. So our Skywire modem is in the Skywire development kit. None of that makes the Skywire development kit particularly special. So let's talk about why I think this is personally the best way to start. So first of all, this gives you a straight USB connection. You can plug this into your computer, fire up your favorite terminal program, and connect to it, and start sending AT commands into it. Very first AT command you'll probably send, as we talked about in the previous video, is just the command AT. When you send AT into the modem, it will respond back OK. Maybe echo back AT and then OK. But that'll give you what you need in order to establish that everything is working. However, one thing you might need to do before you get to that point, after you plug in your power, is use this little button right here. This little button toggles pin 20. Pin 20 is your on-off button. So you're going to hold that down and fire up your modem. Some of these take a little bit longer, some of them take a little bit shorter. So check the chart that's in the user manual, and that'll tell you exactly how long you need to hold that down to fire it up. So that gives you your serial interface. You've got a second USB port, which can be used for firmware updates for the module and USB connectivity, direct USB without a serial conversion. Excuse me. And then you've also got this 14 row header as well right here, or 14 pins, sorry. So these 14 pins can be used to connect your device to an external board. So maybe you're not using an Arduino, maybe you're not talking directly into a computer, you just want to be able to connect the pins and talk to it through some other development board. You can connect into those, and now you're off and running. So that's two different ways you can connect: USB, 14 pins, or you might have already noticed, what is that? That is your standard Arduino pinout. So yes, this can also be an Arduino shield, which is awesome. You do have to flip this little jumper right here to make sure that you're talking over the right serial pins, but then you can pop that right onto an Arduino board and off you go using it just like a shield. So it gives you lots of different cool options to make that work. So that's really why I think this is one of your best options to get started by using a Skywire modem. It just gives you lots of really cool ways to talk to it, lots of ways to interface with it. It's flexible and it's very straightforward. So that is the Skywire development kit. You can find more information. You can also find things like the Gerber files, the design files, the schematics, all sorts of information about the Skywire development kit itself that you can then take and drop into your design and totally use. You're free to use it however you want. It's all out there on the website, which is nimblelink.com/skywire-development-tools. Go there, check it out, see what you can do, and feel free, subscribe to these videos. We're going to be doing more with this stuff. We're going to talk about AT commands. We're going to talk about designing in a project and all sorts of fun stuff. So subscribe so you don't miss future videos. And until then, we'll see you later. Have fun designing. Thank you.